Hello, I am Raymond Daigle. I'm here at the Sonoma International Film Festival. I'm being joined here on stage by Gregory Runnels.
And I go by Greg.
You by Greg, okay. And Mark Runnels, yes. And you guys are here with a short animated film. Tell us the name of it.
It's Breakfast with Bukowski. Yep.
Outstanding. And, well, tell us a little bit about the film. This is not, by the way, your first time to Sonoma International Film Festival.
Well, it's actually our first time at Sonoma International. We were here, I think it was 2006, at the Wine Country Film Festival.
Ah.
I know they're two separate entities.
Okay.
So far, we've had a great time here. We had a blast last night. And
Opening night is always fun.
We were even chauffeured around by the staff, which was a nice surprise because we had been drinking.
Imagine. So tell us about this film that you guys have put together.
Well, it's a four-minute animated short about Charles Bukowski.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to tell them a little bit about Charles Bukowski?
Yeah, Charles Bukowski is a great American writer from the 20th century. And
yes.
Passed away in 1994. And you know, a lot of his stuff was about Skid Row and the down and out. And also a poet and prose writer. So Greg's been trying to make this animated film for the last 7 years.
Whoa.
And finally got it done last fall.
Wow. Why so long?
Animation is very, very expensive. And we're not trust fund babies.
Mm-hmm.
And I really couldn't afford to put together the kind of team that I wanted. And I've actually gone through, I don't draw, so I'm not an animator. So I actually had to hire an animator that would follow my vision. And I would take pictures and sketches, and they would follow that, kind of like working with a cinematographer and an art director and an actor. And my first animator just kind of disappeared with all my sketches, all my books, and that really
set
me
back. That's just rude.
That's just rude. I'm going to hunt him down.
You should.
And the second guy, he just couldn't keep up with it. And the third guy, his name is Frank Cromer. I have to give him his credit. He is a Bukowski fan. And when I got a hold of him, he said, "You found God in Jesus."
Ooh.
I said, "Okay, I'm Catholic, so."
Third time is the charm, apparently.
And he actually knocked it out in 6 weeks.
6 weeks, wow.
What really should have taken 6 months. And he's going to be the lead animator. We're going to work with a team of about 12 artists to do a feature-length film on Charles Bukowski.
Outstanding.
We've already written the screenplay, and Charles Bukowski's widow has given us her blessings to move forward and use any of his literature, anything that's been published, we have the rights to use, which is huge
wow.
for us. Because
I would say so, yes.
He's been published in over 20 languages, over 15 million books printed. I think there's been 4 films about him, soon to be 5.
Soon to be 5. So there's now 4.5 then. You've got
4.5.
That's fantastic. So what was it like directing an animator?
It was a lot of fun. The one good thing about technology is he's out. I haven't actually met him in person.
Oh, really?
Everything's been over the phone, and he lives in Ohio, so he would send me the images through this thing called Dropbox, where you can send huge files. And he would send me something. I would either love it or not like it, and just say, "You got to go back and take this car out. It's too modern." I would either draw a car or get a picture of a car and say, "This is the car I want." He'd send me a dog there's very specific things that I wanted. I wanted a huge dog that looked like it was on steroids, just vicious. And he sent me like a little fox. And I was like, and that's just communication. So it's okay, here, this is what I want. And I took two different dogs and put them together. So uh-huh. It was like almost like a monster. And it was a lot of fun. I mean, it was a blast working with him because he is a fan. And he found some nuance in there that I probably would not have put.
Mm-hmm.
And we like to collaborate. And we collaborated on this, and we're collaborating on the feature, and it is a lot of fun working with an animator. And
it's one of my favorite parts of filmmaking is the collaborative process,
yeah.
and bringing, you know, getting people to bring more to the project than you could have originally imagined.
It's a real pleasure when you see that they have the same vision as you, and you're thinking on the same level, and it's like, okay, I want you to do this. Before I even get to that, he's already done it. You know, it's like, oh, he gets it now.
That's fantastic.
Know? Yeah.
And Greg is also an editor, so the animator would send Greg all the stuff, and Greg was able to cut it together himself.
Yeah, he would actually send me very long scenes, and I wouldn't direct him on that because having more is better, and then I would just pare it down to what I wanted.
You know, I've never edited animation before. What's that like?
It's no different from editing film. Mm-hmm. You know, it's powerful though. It's like, wow, I can actually control this scene. I mean, you're not editing within the scene. You know, I mean, I can't take an object and make it go slow or anything like that. I can just cut. I can pare down a scene.
It always struck me, it just seemed harder to me because it's easy when you make a cut with live action, but you know, when you've decided, well, I don't want this scene, someone's taken so long to draw that out and make it reality. It just seems more painful.
Well, I think it's no different than an actor who's just gave a great performance of his or her life, and it doesn't make it into the movie because it just doesn't fit. Yeah. And it's like, oh.
Sometimes that does happen.
Can you
happen,
put it on the credits? You
know. So what was it like producing this film?
Well, Greg and I have been working together for now almost 20 years.
Ooh.
And, sometimes, one of us will take the lead and the other will follow. This has been Greg's dream to get this done for so long. Mm-hmm. So I really was kind of like, kind of helping him push the rock up the hill. So it was a great experience.
Uh-huh. And now, where is this playing here at the festival?
Well, it just played at 9:15 at Short Film Program 1 over at the Vintage House. It's playing Saturday night at the Community Center, the New Belgium Lounge, where they're going to be serving beer and jerky, I've been told.
Outstanding.
So that's going to be a lot of fun. We've got about 25 of our friends that are going to be there. We're going to go out and party after.
Well, this is exciting because we haven't talked to anybody yet whose film is screened. So what was the experience like?
This is the world premiere.
Oh, my goodness.
It was nice to see it up there with an audience and get people's reactions. And there was also a lot of great filmmakers, great films that were there as well. And that was a pleasure to be sandwiched between those. So, I mean,
that's fantastic.
It was a good experience.
How'd it make you feel?
Oh, accomplished.
Yes, absolutely. And so is the film that you want to make from this, you want to take this short film, expand it to a feature length. Are you looking to keep the same kind of storyline? Are you looking to just for this to be a little bit placed into a larger pan? Or
you can almost look at this as a teaser, as a trailer. I mean, it's the same character, but it's only a four minute short. Mm-hmm. It's basically he's got writer's block and he's trying to find the title. And that's what it is. He goes out and he goes to the track. And I'm not going to give too much away because it's short.
Sure.
But the feature, I'll let him talk about the feature.
Yeah, the feature is essentially going to be an animated biopic about Charles Bukowski.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll start off with him as a child, and we'll end up with him in 1974 when he really starts to get his fame
and
recognition.
And what drew you to the subject matter initially?
Well, we've been Bukowski fans for a long time, like a lot of people. I have no experience in animation, but for some reason, I always saw Bukowski as an animated character. And I think it was probably in about 2004, when I looked back on my journal, that was like the first time I ever really thought about it. Because we would like to do Post Office as a live-action film. You know, his first novel. But in the meantime, I was like, I really want to explore this. I like the challenge of it. I like the challenge that it's something that's completely foreign to me. And there is the whole collaboration with the animator. It was really something that I just wanted to explore. And I thought, he's the perfect character. It's adult animation. It's something for adults. It's not a cartoon.
Do you think you're going to keep the same animator for the whole film or maybe break it up into little bits?
The plan is to have him be the lead animator. He did the whole thing completely on his own.
Mm-hmm.
So he would be the lead animator working with 12 artists, people that would be doing, for people that aren't familiar with animation, in-betweens is everything in between frame 1 and 29 or frame 1 and 24. So he would do the first and the last, and then we'd have the in-between artists doing all that work. And they would also be doing things like building sets, which you actually do.
Mm-hmm.
So it would be him leading the show.
Wow.
And I think he's up for the challenge. And he's already sent me a very nice budget, which, I mean, we're doing this feature film on such a low scale. I mean, I think it's going to be the first independently produced, truly independently produced animated feature.
Well, I want to wish you a lot of luck with that.
Thanks a lot.
Fellas, thank you for coming up and talking with us about your film. Congratulations on being in the film festival here. I hope you have a wonderful time in Sonoma. And again, when is the film showing again?
It's showing Saturday night, 9:30 p.m. at the Community Center, which has been transformed into the new Belgium Lounge.
Outstanding.
Very appropriate.
I encourage everyone to get out and have a look at this fine film. Fellas, thanks a lot.
Thanks for having us.
Have a great time at the festival.
All right.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.